Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Today we are going to discuss Chapter 5, Audit Opinions and Reports. Audit opinions categorize into two categories, unmodified opinion and modified opinion. Auditor opinion generate after the evaluation of the financials of an entity. It's an independent opinion by an auditor with true and fair way according to the international standard of accounts. Auditor opinion varies according to the situation or according to the information what he or she have to find in the financial statements, and after that he write a report according to the opinion for that one company or entity. So auditor opinions as from the chapter is categorized into two forms, modified and unmodified. Let's look at what the unmodified opinion. Unmodified opinion is a very simple. You can find it, or you will see it, most of auditor report. It simply states that the financial statement show true and fair view or present fairly. There are no ifs or buts, mean not to modify. Mean to say that after finding the financial information in the financial statement of an entity, if an auditor found there is a nothing wrong with the financial statement, there is a true and fair presentation of the financial information over there, and as well the financial statement follow the standard of IAS and IFRS, so straightforwardly auditor do not have any reservation and give company a clean or unqualified report. This is the unqualified report or unmodified report. Because of the data according to the standard with true and fair presentation, auditor do not modify his opinion about the company, and strictly he have no reservation and give a clean or unmodified report to the entity. Okay, here we can look the further. Entity report with an unmodified opinion, however, includes all of the following additional paragraphs or sections. Emphasis matter paragraph, material uncertainty, and the other matter paragraph. Emphasis of the matter and other matter paragraph. According to the auditor, when an auditor doing an audit of an entity, he properly read the financial statement, properly evaluate and examine. Somehow few of the factors which he think according to his have to notify the shareholders. Although that information are already declared in the financial statement, but the auditor think over here have to get the attention of the shareholder regarding this one matter. So auditor, apart from his opinion about the financial statement, there is issue or there is a matter which he think have to highlight in the front of the shareholders. So he write a other paragraph or matter paragraph just right below the opinion paragraph, just right very next to the opinion paragraph, and mention that one matter to the shareholder. But because of this matter, the auditor opinion about the financial statement do not change. Simply, so we can say that our auditor can say that this the opinion is not modified in respect of this matter. Let's suppose, here you can see an example, financial statements which describe the effect of fire on the company warehouse. Financial statement which describe already the effect of fire in the company warehouse regarding inventory quantity and the value are mentioned in the financial statement, balance sheet is over there. So according to the financial statement, according to the international standard of accounts, the financial information is true and fair. So auditor have to read that one and give opinion according to the information that. So here, but auditor think that he this thing this matter have to mention in a paragraph, which is namely as other matter paragraph, and emphasize of matter paragraph. He emphasizes the matter of this situation to the shareholder in another paragraph in the auditor report. Okay, the second one is the going concern. Going concern, it's also named as a material uncertainty exist. This is the going concern. It's related to the accounting tool with the management. Management, how operating the company. If a material uncertainty exists, which is adequately disclosed in the financial statement, the auditor is required to draw the attention to the related disclosure in a separate section of the auditor report headed material uncertainty related to going concern. Please wait for a while. Okay, going concern problem, as I told you, it's all about to it's about to the accounting tool accordingly to the management, how they are operating their and operations of the company. So because of this going concern problem, there is a maybe have to mention this one going concern problem in the auditor report with another title of paragraph, material uncertainty related to the going concern. But this going concern problem do not have any effect on the auditor opinion. Generally, if the directors or the auditors think the company might not survive into the foreseeable future, are able to see there is a going concern problem. For foreseeable future, it is not defined, but under IFRS, it should be not less than 12 months from the end of the accounting period. Remember, it is for management to make an assessment of an entity to ability to continue as a going concern, the actual responsibility to obtain sufficient appropriate audit evidence, conclude our report. So, as in this slide, this is mentioned, which is the responsibility of management to see or to predict future operations. Like I can say, the liability of the future, prepayment of something. So this is the problem of management, and this is the responsibility of management. If the management is not focusing, or there is maybe change over there, so auditor have to mention in his audit report about this one going concern problem. But and because of this, auditor do not change his opinion, write no opinion of the financial statement. Here in the example, you can see that there may be a loss faced by a company during the year. And because of this loss, the current liabilities exceeded from total assets, this one. So all are these facts are mentioned in the financial statements. So auditor have to check either these are truly and fairly mentioned in the financial statement or not. Once he check, he make opinion about the financial statement. Clean or unmodified opinion, maybe. But in addition, he think that this is not good for a company. So he under the paragraph of material uncertainty going concern problem mentioned to the shareholder about this one issue to deal with it. Okay. Once the management is responsible to foresee for the future, predict. So what the auditor do over here? Evaluating management plan for future action in relating to its going concern and whether the outcome of these plans are feasible and likely to improve the situation. Auditors have to evaluate management plans for future in relation to the going concern, whether the outcome of these plans are feasible, are likely to improve the situation or not. So he think he have to check this one. He have to check the plans of the management for the future and have to check either this is improving the situation or not. And regarding this one matter, he have to mention the material uncertainty going concern paragraph in his report. Somehow, where the entity has prepared a cash flow forecast, evaluating the reliability of the underlying data generated to prepare the forecast, auditor have to evaluate the reliability of the data that is generating to prepare the forecast. If the company is going to forecast the cash flow, so auditor duty is here to evaluate the reliability on what data, on what type of reliability of the data because of this cash flow are forecasted. Either it's a original one, or this a reliable, or this is a good one or not. Second, determine whether there is adequate support of the assumption underlying the forecast. So over the plans are predicted. So for the plans, predicted plans over here, having the adequate information, adequate supportive with it or not to fulfill the plan or not. So considering whether additional facts of information have become available since the date on which management made its assessment. Also have to check the date, whether the data, adequate data, how, when it is collected for the future plan by the. So this is the going concern problem regardingly, according to the management. Auditor have to check, is there any problem with the going concern? He have to mention, notify to the auditor and but do not change his opinion. Effect of going concern problem on the auditor report. Okay, very simple. If there is a problem with the going concern data, so the problem with the financial reports. If there is no problem with the going concern problem, this you need, according to you have to think this will be, so you have to notify it. But if there is a misassertion, misstatement of the data in the going concern problem, so it means to say that the financial statement, the future predicted plans, predicted forecast cash flows, forecasted cash flows are not truly and fairly. So here you modified your opinion that the forecasted cash flows are not true and fair because the going concern problem is over here of a misleading or misassertion of the data. Okay, look toward the modify audit opinion. It's a modify. Auditor opinion, modify, auditor opinion change vary according to the situation. Over here, look toward the slide. The financial statement include one or more material misstatements. Maybe the financial statement having one or more than one material misstatements, misassertions. The facts are not true. Misleading data over there. Wrong data is over there. So one situation is this, and this situation modify the auditor opinion. And he mentioned it in the report according to this one opinion. The auditor has been unable to obtain sufficient appropriate audit evidence. Auditor have not sufficient evidences. So he or she unable to clear the audit report. So he will be clear it as a disclaimer report. However, modification can be done through different ways. The first one is the qualified report, qualified opinion. Before this slide, I have to tell you about the modify. According to the situation, the auditor opinion is modified and he write the report according to his opinion, this the modified opinion. The first one is the qualified opinion, and because of this auditor write a qualified report for an entity. Qualified opinion is like that material is true and fair in the financial statement, and the financial statement are according to the IAS and IFRS. everything is okay. There is nothing wrong with the financial statement. But here, like suppose, there is a value of fixed asset calculated by the management is 110 rupees for an, let's suppose for an X asset. And but by the calculation of an auditor, its value is 100. And there is a gap of 10%, up to 10% increases in the financial statements. But already this is disclosed in the financial statement with true and fairly. So auditor have the reservation over here. Auditor said that everything is true and fair in the financial statement, but the assertion, but the figure of X asset is not calculated according to the market. It may be management calculated according to the economic life of an asset, and the auditor is calculating the according to the market value. So maybe the auditor calculation and the management calculation for X asset is not matching. There is a gap of 10% over there. So auditor having the reservation, and he clear this report as a qualified report. The second one is the adverse report. Adverse, the meaning of adverse is bad. As unqualified, clean report is a good one report because the assertion are true and fair over there. And here in adverse, it means to say that the assertion, the values, the facts, the figure in the financial statement are misstated. Everything is wrong with, maybe most of the things are wrong, one or more than one. Fraudulent activities are performed in the financial statements. In this situation, the auditor opinion is changed from, you can say the first was the unmodified opinion, the second was the qualified opinion, and this is the third is adverse opinion. The situation is changed. What situation is changes over there? The assertion is misleading, the assertion wrong in the financial statement. So auditor clear it as an adverse report. The third one is the disclaimer report. Disclaimer report, when an auditor have not find anything, such evidences, on the behalf of the evidences, he can make the opinion about the financial statement of an entity. So, like an example of record burning, admin record is burned, fire in the office of admin. So because of this, all the data is burned. So data is unavailable, or you can say evidence is not available. So auditor is unable to form opinion. So he will not say the company financial are adverse, or he cannot make opinion the company is unqualified or clean, or you can say it's adverse. So he clear it as a disclaimer report. So in this slide, this discuss the disclaimer option. So auditor declare is add a disclaimer report because of disclaimer opinion, and disclaimer opinion because of the situation of the unavailability of the data. Okay, here is a qualification matrix. Very simple. Nature of circumstances. Yes, we know. Financial statement contain a material misstatement. First nature. Second nature, unable to obtain sufficient appropriate evidence. Yes, we studied. It's mean to that there is a disclaimer opinion over there. Okay. Material were not pervasive and pervasive. Sufficient, supportive. So if the financial statement having the material misstatement and the except for mean to say the value of X of an asset increased, mentioned 10% up to 10% in 10% high according to the calculation of an auditor. So he declare a qualified report. And when the he find more than that, there is a more than one asset, there is a more than one value is misleading assertion over the information, he declare as an adverse opinion. Similarly, on an unavailability, he strictly declare the report as a disclaimer report because of disclaimer opinion. Thank you very much. This is from today.